Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to install the latest version of Python, that is Python 3.9.7 in Windows 10 operating system. And then I'll also show you how to run a simple Python program in your Windows 10 operating system. So let's begin. Now to install Python, you need to just simply go to your favorite browser and in the address bar, you need to just simply type Python download, then enter. And then you'll be seeing this www.python.org is basically our first search result. So just, you know, simply click on download the latest version of Python. And this will, you know, going to redirect you to this official site of Python. And here you can clearly see we have this download button for downloading Python 3.9.7. To download Python, just simply double click on it. And this will, you know, going to start downloading our Python. You can clearly see it has, you know, rightly started downloading. Since I have already downloaded it, I just, you know, simply cancel it. And if I just simply minimize my browser, and if I just simply go to my download directory, you can clearly see we have Python 3.9.7 rightly downloaded over here. Now to install, just simply double click on it. And this will, you know, going to launch our install Python 3.9.7 wizard. So just, you know, simply minimize our download directory, and this is basically our installation wizard, right? In here, you need to check this @python3.92 path. That's a very important step. Do check that, right? And then you need to just, you know, simply click on custom installation. And this will, you know, going to open this window. In here, you need to just, you know, simply click on next. And in the advanced option, it will ask you whether you'd like to install for all users. So I am going to recommend you to check this install for all users so that this path, this customized installation location get, you know, user friendly, like just Python 3.9, that is Python 3.9 folder will be created, right? And then keep everything other as default and then just simply click on install. And then it will ask you for administrative privileges. So for that, just simply click on yes. And you can clearly see our installation has been, you know, rightly begun. Right, so this might take a couple of minutes, so what we'll be doing is I'll be coming back after installing Python. Yeah, so we'll come back, and now as you can clearly see, our Python setup was successful. So just, you know, simply click on close. And now if you just simply go to your command prompt, and in here if you just simply type Python space --version, then enter, you can clearly see our latest version of Python, that is Python 3.9.7, has been, you know, rightly installed on our machine. Right, so now that we have rightly installed the latest version of Python, that is Python 3.9.7, it's time to write a simple code snippet in Python. So for that, if you just simply type here Python, then enter, you can clearly see our popular Python shell has been, you know, rightly opened with this trademark 3 angular bracket, right? In here, let's say you want to print something in our console. So for that, if you just simply type print, then in the double quotes, if you just, you know, simply type hello world, and if you just simply click on enter, you can clearly see this hello world has been, you know, rightly shown in our console. Similarly, let's say you want to add to number. So let's say you want to add 8 + 5. Then, you know, just simply type that, and if you just simply click on enter, you can clearly see this 13, the required answer has been, you know, rightly shown in our console. Let's say you want to assign some values to two variables. Let's say you want to assign 5 to variable A. Similarly, you want to assign, you know, 7 to variable B. And let's say you want to just simply add these two numbers. So A + B, you'll be getting this 12, right? Similarly, let's say you want to divide these two number, so A / B, you'll be getting the required value, right? So all these things you can do in Python shell. You can also write us, you know, hello world program. So I'm going to, you know, show that. So for that, you need to just simply click on this toolbar, and now if you just simply type idle, you'll be getting this Python idle app over here. So just, you know, simply click on that. And this is, you know, going to launch our Python idle. And you can clearly see our Python idle shell 3.9.7 has been rightly opened. In here, you can do all the same operations that I have done in the command prompt. You can do the same thing over here, right? So just for an example, if I just, you know, show you this simple addition, sorry, 8 + 4, You can see it is coming rightly over here. But let's say you want to write a complete program. So for that, you need to just simply click on File, then New File. And now let's say if you want to print something in our console. So for that, just simply type Hello and World. And if you just simply end with in the bracket and then go to File, then Save As, you'll be getting this window over here. Now you need to just simply go to this document folder, and you need to just simply create a new folder. So let's create a folder as Python_practice, right? So we are practicing, so we just wanted to create that Python practice folder. And in here, let's give a file name as prog.py. That's a very important, this py is very important for Python. To write any Python program, you need to save it as .py extension, right? And then you need to just simply click on Save, and you can clearly see our program has been rightly saved over here with prog.py, right? And if you just simply click on Run and then click on Run Module, you can clearly see our Hello World has been rightly shown over here. In here, you can write a simple program as well. So let's say you want to multiply two number, so you can assign two number over here. So just simply assign those number, and in the print statement, if you just simply multiply these two number, let's say A into B, and if you just simply click on Run button, and then if you just simply click on Run Module, you can clearly see it is going to ask that whether you like to save it or not. So it's very important to save our program first. So just simply click on OK, and you can clearly see 10 has been rightly shown. This Hello World is actually coming from the first print statement, and 10, that is what we are getting by multiplying this two number, 2 into 5, right? So in this way, you can easily install the latest version of Python in your industrial operating system, and you can test your Python shell by writing a simple Python program. So there are several IDEs available for Python. So I have already made a video about PyCharm, so you can watch that video. I'll be putting the link in the description. So by using PyCharm IDE, it will going to give you a very good coding interface where you can write Python program, right? So for that, do subscribe our channel and also watch all those videos that are there in my channel, right? So that's basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you like this video, then please give it a like, and so do share it with your friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.